Good morning. This is Wednesday, July 13th. Today's devotion is The Price of the Vision. This is Isaiah 6:1. In the year that King Uzziah died, I saw the Lord. Our soul's personal history with God is often an account of the death of our heroes. Over and over again, God has to remove people, our friends, to put himself in their place. And that is when we may falter and fail and become discouraged. Let me think about this personally. When the person died who represented for me all that God was, in other words, the person that led you to the Lord and discipled you, when they were gone, did I give up on everything in life? Did I become ill or disheartened? Or did I do as Isaiah did, see the Lord? My vision of God is dependent upon the condition of my character, spiritually and morally. My vision of God, how I see God, is how I am spiritually and how I am morally. That character will determine how we see God. My character determines whether or not truth can be revealed to me when I do see Him. Before I can say, I saw the Lord, like Isaiah did, there must be something in my character that conforms to the likeness of God. Until I am born again and really begin to see the kingdom of God, I only see the perspective of my own biases. In other words, the way I want to see them, what I think I should be able to see and what they should look like. What I need is God's surgical procedure, His use of external circumstances to bring about an internal purification in that spiritual and moral character. Your priorities must be God's first, God second, God third, until your life is continually face to face with God and no one else is taken into account whatsoever. What Oswald is saying is the more you surrender to God every step you take, the other things will just fall into line. You'll be so at peace with what God's doing, you won't have to keep stopping and rechecking and checking. You'll just walk forward. It's not that we have disregard for the people that we love, but we give them to God, and then we trust what He shall do with them. Your prayer will be then, in all the world, there is no one but you, God. There is no one but you. Keep praying, keep paying the price. Let God see that you are willing to live up to the vision. The challenge I have is, who can take the place of God or Jesus Christ in what we focus on every day? Is the Lord what we focus on? Or is there somebody else or something else that's always, it always has priority before God? Good challenge. Let's pray. Father, I pray today if there's somebody in the way that's stopping up our vision of you, seeing you, like Isaiah did, I pray, Lord, that we would be at peace with you removing that issue, or at least giving us peace to release it to you. We love you, Lord, and we pray for this vision of you and your Son being first, second, and third in our lives every day. We pray this in Christ's name. Amen. God bless, and I'll see you tomorrow.